This bristlecone pine tree, known as Methuselah, is the oldest known living thing in the world. It has survived for about 5,000 years high in the barren, cold, dry, windy, white mountains of California. This extreme habitat doesn't seem like the kind of place that would foster a long life like Methuselah's, but it's actually a big part of the reason Methuselah has been able to live for so long. Hi, I'm David, and this is Minute Earth. Some of the planet's longest living organisms, including bristlecone pines, only get super old because the adaptations that help them survive the different harsh conditions they all live in are the same kinds of adaptations that help them live long lives. For example, because there's so little water this high in the White Mountains, bristlecones like Methuselah have evolved to grow really slowly, less than 1/100th the speed of most other trees. And that slow growth helps bristlecones live longer, too. It means that their thick cell walls are packed extremely tightly together, making their wood way too dense for potential killers like bacteria, fungi, and beetles to munch through. And to survive the violent windstorms in the area, bristlecones like Methuselah have developed a weird, redundant internal architecture, unlike that of other trees. When wind or lightning damages another kind of tree, it often breaks the flow of nutrients from the roots to the branches, killing the entire thing. But bristlecones have bodies that are subdivided into thin sections that each carry their own flow of nutrients. This way, some parts can be damaged, and even die, without harming the rest of the tree. This architecture also helps really old bristlecones, like Methuselah, keep on ticking because they only have to sustain a few small remaining sections. And bristlecones are one of the only trees whose seeds can germinate in the super high pH soil of the White Mountains, which means that they face very little competition for the area's scarce resources. That basic fact also means that bristlecones have almost no neighbors, so the kind of once-in-a-century mega forest fires that can torch other old trees are really unlikely to reach them. And bristlecone pines aren't the only super old extremophiles. It turns out that a lot of Earth's oldest organisms have their habitats to thank for all the extra candles on their birthday cakes. Tube worms, for example, face almost no competition in the pitch-black hydrocarbon seeps at the bottom of the ocean, so they can live relatively undisturbed for as long as 170 years. Greenland sharks have super slow metabolisms to help them survive the frigid waters where they live, and this pokey pace of life delays their aging. Some can live for 400 years. And welwitschia plants, which grow in the middle of the parched Namib desert, only ever grow two raggedy leaves. This simple structure seems to be easy to maintain in a resource-poor environment. The oldest welwitschias can live for more than 2,000 years. It turns out that, sometimes at least, the secret to an extremely long life is to go to extremes. And here's something else that's extremely cool. We have made our own interactive course that's now available at brilliant.org. It's about molecular representation. Like all of Brilliant's awesome courses, it's visually based, hands-on, and full of bite-sized info that progresses from the basics all the way up to advanced level stuff. And it's made in MinuteEarth's signature style, so we know it will be perfect for lifelong learners who want to stay sharp, like you. To get started for free, visit brilliant.org/MinuteEarth or click the link in the description. The first 200 of you will get 20% off Brilliant's annual premium subscription.